Hey there. It's been a long time. Welcome back to Cooking Adventures. So yeah, it's been over a year since I've done a cooking adventure. You may or may not have known that I moved into a new house.
Yep.
You are probably used to seeing me in a teeny tiny kitchen that was actually in a hallway in my apartment. Good reminder right there of the situations I was dealing with. So now I have lots and lots of space. Lots and lots of space. All kinds of countertop space. And I have a butcher block on an island. And I have a cat on the table. Yeah. Oh, yes, you know you're not supposed to be on the table, but you do it anyway. And more counter space. So, there you have it. We are going to have ourselves an adventure in the kitchen today. Yes, we are. So basically, moving into this house was kind of a huge deal for me last year. I'd been living in an apartment for a pretty long time, so I had a lot of stuff to move, and it was a bit stressful, and that's why I really couldn't keep to my commitment to doing cooking adventures. But now that I'm sort of set up in my house now, and I'm feeling a little bit better about this whole space, I think we can start doing cooking adventures again. I found a fantastic recipe for a chorizo biscuit gravy combination, and it's got like radishes and avocado on top. It's basically like nachos with biscuits. Not really sure what you would call that. Biscuits or bachos or something. So we're just gonna make biscuits and chorizo gravy, and we're just gonna have a good time and hopefully not burn down my kitchen. So, let's do it.
First of all, we are going to make biscuits. In the original recipe, it says that we need to make them from cornmeal, but I didn't buy cornmeal because I'm lazy. So, instead, Jiffy buttermilk biscuits. Preheat oven to 450. Put that shit on. Boom. Blend biscuit mix and water into soft dough. Got it. Oh my god, please. Stop. Go in the bowl. Maybe. Turn the dough onto a lightly floured surface. Knead 2 to 3 times. I hate kneading dough. I don't like the feeling of flour on my hands. It feels like nails on a chalkboard. And it really bugs me. I'm not really sure why that's a thing, but it does. I just hate it. It like sends chills up my back. It's sticking to me. Oh god, it's sticking to me. I have not improved any in the last couple years, I should say. You know, I'm just still just as pathetic as I was. Liking the feel of flour and not being able to knead a basic biscuit. I mean, look at me. You're not doing your job, flour. You're not supposed to be making sticks. The fudge. Yep. More flour. I feel like I've used enough flour now that this should not be a problem still. What's the matter with this? Why? Stop sticking to me. This is ridiculous. Just enough of your shenanigans. Oh my god. Oh my god. Stop it. Stop. Just enough. crap in all the bowls, in all the craps. This is to roll or pat out to half an inch thick, and then cut with 2.5 floured cutter and place on ungreased baking tape. We're not gonna do that. That's so many extra steps, and this thing is being a blubbery piece of shit. So we're putting it in the muffin pan. I've managed to fuck up the whole recipe because somehow I didn't get enough oil, and I think maybe it's because I didn't put two whole lengths of chorizo in. Shoot. Shooty shoot! Now we're gonna add milk. Not very much, though, because we didn't apparently use a pound of chorizo. We used 8 ounces because I wanted to save some. So we're gonna be very, very careful about this. Holy shit! Holy shit, don't burn! Oh my god. Good job. You scalded the milk in the pan. There are supposed to be gravy things happening. There is no such thing in here. It's way too dry. Well, so it's not gravy anymore. It's just sort of like breaded chorizo on biscuits. It's a very carb-happy dinner we're about to have. It's not gravy. It's just not gravy. It's just not. Well, it just looks bad. And there's no way around it. I tried. I failed. I managed to exhaust the batteries in my camera. This is what I've been filming on. That has not changed. God, the resolution on this is freaking awful. The phone is actually like precariously balanced on the edge of the kitchen island right now, leaning very delicately on the sugar bowl. I am hoping that it doesn't fall. it took me forever to actually just clear out the camera on the phone because I had too much stuff on here. And realized that during that, the pizza stone was in the oven cooking at the 450 degrees for that entire amount of time. So I can't stand how it feels. Oh my god, I can't do it. I'm good, man. Get out of me. I feel like there's enough flour here that it shouldn't be so sticky anymore. And yet it's just not doing its job. So I just found out that my phone only has enough space on it for 5 minutes at a time. So I'm gonna have to film this entire cooking adventure 5 minutes at a time. Because the other camera is dead. Look at this crap. I have been rolling this around in flour for the last, you know, I don't care. It's fine. I don't care. I do care a little bit. I care so much. I hate biscuits. I hate them so much right now. Where is this flour coming from? It's coming off of... Please, I swear I'm never doing it. So here it is. Woo! Stupid rod.